Earning gold bars in Red Dead Online is extremely important, as it is the premium currency used by Rockstar for this game, and it's needed to unlock big pieces of content like the 5 roles and the Bounty Hunter expansion, certain horses, certain items and equipment for your character, and much more. And now that Red Dead Online is standalone, if you're a new player, you're probably wondering how you can get the leg up on earning gold bars so you don't have to worry so much about grinding and you can just jump right into the action. Today, I present to you my entire guide on the best and only ways of earning gold in Red Dead Online. No matter the type of player you are, there is something in here for everyone, so let's get started. If you enjoy this video at any point, or if you just find it helpful, let me know by dropping a like on this video, and if you want to stay up to date and in the loop with everything Red Dead Redemption 2 and Red Dead Online, consider hitting that subscribe button with your bell notifications turned on. When trying to earn gold, it's important to remember that activities that pay you in gold like missions, dynamic events with timers, random encounters, PvP showdown, horse races, all of that, they are all time-based. This means that it doesn't necessarily matter how good of a shot you are, how many kills you get, and really what you do as long as you just complete the objective, and depending on the time you spent completing the mission, you're awarded an arbitrary amount of gold, so this is a good spot to discuss all missions and activities first. As a player, you're earning gold immediately after starting a mission. Sometimes the countdown timer on your screen will appear right away, like on most Stranger missions and PvP, but sometimes, on bounties for example, the majority of dynamic events as well, you'll encounter in the free roam, there will be a hidden timer. Ignore the timer on your screen. Not completely, as it is still the game telling you how much time you have left until failure and until you fail the mission and don't earn rewards, but that timer in no way affects how much gold you're paid out at the end of the mission. The gold payouts are broken down into the following time intervals. At 3 minutes into the mission, you'll make 8 gold nuggets, then at 6 minutes, you'll make another 8, amounting to 16 gold nuggets total. At 9 minutes, you'll make another 8 gold nuggets, bringing your total up to 24 gold. Then at 12 minutes, 32 gold nuggets in total. 15 minutes, we drop down to 36 gold nuggets in total, which you can see we drop from 8 nuggets per 3 minutes to only 4 nuggets per 3 minutes. And then the time also increases to 20 minutes, where you make 40 gold nuggets in total, 25 minutes for 44 gold nuggets. And then the pay cap is at 30 minutes, with 48 gold nuggets being the maximum amount possible to earn on any single mission, regardless of time. As you can see, 12 minutes is the optimal amount of time you want to spend on activities that pay you in gold. Any less time spent means you have the potential to earn more and are wasting that opportunity, and spending more than 12 minutes means you're spending too much time on that mission for the gold you're earning. It's diminishing returns for your time at that point. While you spend 12 minutes on these missions, I recommend you do daily challenges for additional gold per minute, or you can go hunting, or what I prefer is to go collecting, or you can catch up on picking herbs for your tonics, and so you can also season your meats. Multitasking collector and bounty hunter and also daily challenges is a great way to supercharge both your money and your gold grind. Now, one thing to note for older players, as of the new Bounty Hunter expansion update, money payouts have changed on the free roam bounties and just the free roam bounties. And with that comes a new exception to this rule if you're looking to earn optimal money and gold over time. But since this video is strictly gold based, remember the time is 12 minutes. I'll have a video on all the best ways to earn money in Red Dead Online and the new free roam bounty payout changes will be discussed in that video, as there is some confusion over what exactly is going on and how long you should spend on each free roam bounty now for optimal money. But remember, it's just different and completely separate from these gold payouts we're talking here today. Now, one of the best ways to earn gold, the next that we're going to be talking about, is by searching for gold bars and treasure chests. You need a treasure map in order to do this, and with the updated spawns, it just becomes a lot easier for all players. Typically, you'll earn about a gold bar and $100 from these maps, although it's really just RNG and it can vary to as low as less than half a gold bar, or even greater than $150 sometimes. The good thing is you're always guaranteed gold and cash at the same time from these treasures, and also as a foundation for this, in Red Dead Online, all players earn a treasure map every 5 levels when they rank up, and even past level 100, you will still be earning treasure maps every 5 levels. It will just be harder and harder to rely on those, of course, because the XP required to rank up becomes so great. But not to worry though, as there are other reliable methods of earning treasure maps. Looting bodies is also an extremely important method, as enemies sometimes are carrying treasure maps on them, and that's why you always see me looting bodies in my gameplays, as I'm trying to give myself the chance to loot as many maps as possible. This is also RNG from looting bodies, but you can probably loot a map every couple of hours of gameplay if you're consistently doing missions where you're looting bodies. There's also certain activities you can involve yourself in to further increase your chances of those maps spawning on a body. For example, while there's only a certain percentage chance to loot a map off of a normal enemy during a stranger mission or a bounty, for example, there is an increased chance if you loot an enemy during a gang hideout, an ambush, or one of those animal poaching outposts, which are those camps with the big cages where you need to free one of the animals. Now, finally, there are specific dynamic events and random encounters as well, where the game gives you treasure maps for free. One is finding rival treasure hunters that you can easily spot by looking out on big cliff sides for NPCs, and they're waving around a map or they're peering through their binoculars. If you find one of those guys, you can either buy the map off them, or I would just recommend you punch or shove them for the map. You'll pick it up right away, and if you want to take it a step further, you can knock them out or kill them and loot their body for a possibility of earning a second map from them. Trust me, it happens way more than you think, so go all out. Now, the second encounter is a treasure map nailed to a tree. You can find these at night because a lantern is located nearby, illuminating the tree with the map nailed to it. And both of these events, it's important to keep in mind that they both have a 3 real life day cooldown. So you can't get another one of these events to spawn until 72 hours have passed, unfortunately. And also, side note, for anyone looking to stock up treasure maps, you can only carry up to 40 maps, including post office or camp lockbox duplicates as well, at a time. So make sure you don't go over that threshold, otherwise the game will completely stop spawning them for you. This means that in the events that you rank up every 5 levels where you would normally earn a map, you won't get those anymore. So just keep an eye on your stockpile if you're one of those players like me who prefer to just stock up 20 or 30 at a time before you start to go after a bunch. Now, a third method of earning gold bars fast are, of course, through your daily challenges. This was one of the best ways of earning gold, and Rockstar decided to nerf it by 50% in the recent Bounty Hunter update. But that being said, it is still far more efficient for earning gold bars over time than anything else in the game. No reason to dwell in the past and reminisce over the old daily challenge pay system, so let's just focus entirely on the new one for 2020, 2021, and beyond, barring any other changes from Rockstar. You are now earning 10 gold nuggets per daily challenge without any sort of daily challenge streak, which would give you a multiplier. So, between the 7 normal daily challenges and 9 roll daily challenges, if and when you unlock enough rolls to complete 9 roll daily challenges, you will also earn a bonus for completing the normal dailies and a bonus for completing the roll dailies as well, which amounts to 2.2 gold bars per day just from those challenges. If you complete 7 normal daily challenges and 9 roll dailies every single day for 1 week, that's 15.4 gold bars in total just from the challenges. Now, at week 2, you're rewarded with a 1.5 times multiplier on the gold you're paid out per challenge you complete, which comes out to 15 gold nuggets per challenge completed in week 2. That's 3.3 gold bars a day completing all 7 challenges and 9 roll challenges for a total of 23.1 gold bars in week 2 of your streak. In week 3, you now have a 2 times multiplier on the gold you earn from challenges, which comes out to 4.4 gold bars per day and 30.8 gold bars for week 3 if you've completed all the challenges. And finally, for week 4, at a 21 plus day streak, you will earn a 2.5 times multiplier, which is 5.5 gold bars per day and 38.5 gold bars for the entire week. If you add up the 15.4 gold bars from week 1, 23.1 from week 2, 30.8 from week 3, and then finally 38.5 gold bars for week 4, that amounts to a grand total of 107.8 gold bars in just 1 month from completing every single one of your daily challenges. Now, that is a perfect world example, and not everyone will get all of the dailies done per day. They may not even get one daily done per day, and they may lose their streak, unfortunately. And this just shows that you can earn 107.8 gold bars every single month. But when you hit 28 day streaks now in this game, the game will reset you back to zero. And so unfortunately, you have to keep building it up every single time. Whereas before, you could have kept going past 28 days and people had hundreds and hundreds of days of streaks built up. But nonetheless, 107.8 gold bars is how the math works out if you're a completionist and you complete everything that month. For the time you spend on daily challenges, it is more than worth it than anything else in the game still, depending on how quick or how slow you are from doing daily challenges. But with the nerf, unfortunately, obviously as you can tell, it is a lot less effective than it was before with this recent Bounty Hunter update. Now let's discuss one of the final methods of earning gold bars fast and how you can go about doing so. Resetting the awards in your progress tab is also an extremely great way of earning gold just for playing the game. There's awards, for example, where if you get 1,000 kills or 1,000 headshots, you can reset the award back to zero and you will earn 40 gold nuggets for completing it. There are too many awards that you can reset for me to list here in this video, so I won't, but the ones you can reset up to 10 times, meaning, for example, in the 1,000 kills award, you can reset it 10 times for 10,000 kills, and you will earn 4 entire gold bars for doing so. Just check the awards tab yourself in the progress pause menu, as there are some really easy ones like picking plants and selling them to a doctor, in which you can farm easily if you need some quick gold right this second without too much work. Now, as a nice mention as well, added in this update, max level bounty hunters are also able to earn gold bars just for getting bounty hunter XP, and it works out to the following amounts. If you earn 10,000 bounty hunter XP past max level bounty hunter, you can reset that award and you will earn $100 and 50 nuggets each time you reset that award, and to my understanding, you can do it in unlimited amount of time. So I hope they allow this feature with other roles, because that means everyone who's max level in those roles can also earn extra gold from those roles in the future if they do decide to do that. All in all, there are lots of great ways to earn gold bars fast in Red Dead Online, and if you really want to get down to grinding these and sinking time into using these methods that we talked about in this video instead of just coasting by using them, you're going to get some serious amounts of gold bars per month, and the more options players have, the better, I think, here. Because with all of that said, that is where we're going to wrap up the video here today. Thank you so much for watching. Hopefully you all enjoyed the video today, and if you did, hopefully I earned your like on it. And of course, if you are new to my channel and want to stay up to date with all the best Red Dead Online and Rockstar Games content, consider hitting that subscribe button so you don't miss out on a single thing. We constantly talk about updates, news, information, tips, tricks, and even leaks. We'll keep you guys updated here on the channel daily, so make sure you hit that subscribe button. If you guys also want to follow me over on Twitch, Twitter, and Instagram, those are the best places to get connected with me outside of YouTube. You're more than welcome to ask me any questions on there. You can follow me at HazardousHDTV, and all of my social media links can be found in the description down below. With that being said, thank you all so much for watching. I hope you all have a fantastic day, and I will see you guys in the next Red Dead Online video. Adios, amigos.